the JAMA Network.
This patient is undergoing a laparoscopy. The operation is done with small incisions, smaller instruments, and a fiber optic scope to see inside the abdomen. Most times, the patient has less pain and a quicker recovery compared to a traditional open procedure that involves making a large incision. This technique works well for treating colon cancer.
Rectal cancer, which is at the other end of the GI tract, at the very bottom of the colon, is a different ball game. There is a high risk of local recurrence of the tumor in the pelvis after an operation, no matter whether you do it open or anything else.
Dr. James Fleshman from Baylor University Medical Center and co-authors wanted to know if a minimally invasive approach was as good as an open procedure for patients with stage 2 or 3 rectal cancer.
We wanted to make sure that we were giving our patients the best chance for curing their cancer, not just giving them the advantage of a small incision and a minimally invasive approach.
486 patients were randomly assigned to receive a standard open operation or the minimally invasive laparoscopic approach. All the procedures were done by 46 highly trained surgeons. Specimens from each procedure were examined under a microscope to see whether the entire tumor was removed, known as a complete resection.
Patients who underwent an open operation, 90% of all the patients had the complete resection. In the laparoscopy group, only 81.7% of patients ended up with a complete resection.
The study appears in JAMA, Journal of the American Medical Association.
That told us that laparoscopy for rectal cancer was not as good as open operation for rectal cancer.
Dr. Fleshman also says tumor location is important.
So if this is a very straightforward, small tumor, and the surgeon is comfortable in stating that this will be able to be done perfectly, then laparoscopy may be the appropriate way to go. In a tumor that's very deep in the pelvis and very large, laparoscopy may not be the right way to treat this anymore.
Catherine Dolph, the JAMA Report.